Well, hi everyone. Welcome to the free online training today. It's going to be top five mistakes you're making with Facebook ads. This is material that we share with our clients, usually high level consulting. So you're going to get a ton of stuff, value in here, I hope. Probably run about 45 minutes or so. If you need to bail out, no problem at all. I will email you the recording of this and some material. So you'll be able to share that with your colleagues, so do with it as you please. At the end, we'll be telling you about the Facebook Ads Intensive program that we run, and I have already drawn a lucky winner of someone who is attending, who's already on the call right now, could be you, who will get that program absolutely for free. So you'll want to make sure you stick around to the end for that. So let me just do a quick check here to make sure everything is okay computer-wise. I upgraded to the new version of Keynote, and it makes me nervous a little bit, I'll tell you. So let's get started with Facebook advertising, or as the typo says, I just noticed, Facebook ads. Oh my good grief. See, this is what happens when you try to switch to decaf in the middle of the week. So Facebook ads is an incredibly effective way of getting people to like your page, of promoting it. Most of you, I can tell from conversion tracking, which we'll talk about, most of you who are on this webinar came here because you saw an ad in the newsfeed that was targeted directly to you. These can be incredibly effective, and fairly, I see the same mistakes being made over and over again. I see people paying a dollar per like when there's ways to get that way down. People don't know whether the ads are effective, and there's tools buried in Facebook to help you do that, to understand exactly, so I can tell you exactly how much I paid per acquisition of a registration on this webinar. Tools that are already in Facebook and a lot of people don't know it. But let's talk about the biggest, perhaps the biggest mistake that I see people making, and they make it because it's easy to do on Facebook. Now, we talk about Facebook ads, we're not talking about posting stuff to your brand page. That happens automatically, that's for free. We're talking about giving Facebook a little bit of money to help you out. So, the first mistake is people boost posts. So what am I talking about? So here's an example of a post that I created. If you have a Facebook brand page, and by the way, this won't work on any personal profile. You only get these advertising tools on your brand page. So down at the bottom right there, you'll see boost post. What Facebook says is we'll feeds than we would organically or ordinarily. This is an important thing to understand. Facebook and Twitter operate very differently when it comes to displaying your content. So let's say that you have a Twitter account for your company and a Facebook page for your company. When you post on Twitter, every single post that you post, every single tweet you send, is potentially viewable by people who follow you. So they go to that home screen of Twitter, the main page, and they will see, now provided they're there at the time that, you know, or they keep scrolling down, but Twitter doesn't filter anything out. If you've posted it and people are there at the time and they're reviewing their Twitter feed, they will see your post. Facebook's not like that. Facebook, excuse me, I've got a cold this morning. Facebook, on the other hand, will filter some of your content out. Not everything you post on your brand page makes it to the news feed of your fans, of people who've already indicated an interest in your page. And they filter it out using something called edge to hack it, to get it a bit more viral, and we go into all sorts of details on that on the Facebook Ads Intensive program, which I'll tell you about at the end. But the most effective way to get it on more of your fans' news feeds is to boost the post, is to pay Facebook a little bit of money to put it there. So when you click boost post on any post that you've got, a little thing like this pops up. Now we used to be able to say to Facebook, I want to give you, you know, X number of dollars, and the more money you give, the more people it'll send it out to. I want to give X number of dollars, and I want you to show this post to more of my fans. Facebook took this option away a little while ago, and now you're forced into people who like your page, that's your fans, and all of their friends. There's another version that you can see there called people you choose through targeting, and that's even broader. That's not necessarily your fans or their friends. That's just, you know, gender, age, and rough location. But this is the problem with boosting a post in this way, and I'll show you the right way to do it. But the problem with doing it this way, the shortcut, that little icon down there in the bottom in the post, is because it is a shortcut, right? And you do not get access to a lot of stuff. For instance, you cannot target interest. So when I posted something about this particular webinar, you know, I said, I want this to reach people who are small business owners who are already interested in digital marketing or who follow people who talk about digital marketing in some way. So quite important that you do that, that you stay away from boosted posts. It's quick and it's dirty, but it doesn't work very effectively. You can't track conversions, you can't rename your ads, you can't even create a similar ad. There's a right way to do this, however, and it's to set up a promoted post. That's different than a boosted post, and I'll show you that in just a second. But there's a very good methodology if you try to decide which post to promote, and it's Jay Baer at Convincing Convert came up with it. It's called the STIR. Now I'll send you the slides on this, so don't worry about copying this down. But it's a four stage sort of a checklist, and if your post matches these things, then it works pretty well. However, that's the problem with boosted posts. Let me show you the right way to do it. The right way to do it is to use a promoted post instead. So here's how you do it. Let's go to my brand page here. And I'm going to find a post that I want to promote. Well, let's say this one here, where it says, looking forward to presenting this morning at the BC SCA conference. So if I were to click boost post, you know, of course, I can back to this post here. Now this was a speech I gave yesterday to the BC School Counselors Association. So I might want to reach out to people who are in education. So there's no shortcut to creating a boosted post right on your page. Instead, what we want to do is go over to the Ads Manager. If you've got the new newsfeed, it's this little chart icon here on the left. Otherwise, you can usually find it by pulling down the top arrow in the top right. So let's start. You create an ad. You always start by creating an ad. The first thing it wants to know is, where do you want clicks to go? So if someone clicks on your ad after seeing it, where do we want them to go? And you can put in a website address. You can say, I want them to go, now this isn't going to promote a post, of course, but I want them to go to my website. And that's fine. The problem with that is that it's going to cost you a lot more to send it off Facebook. But I want to promote something on my brand page, so I'm going to select my brand page there. And it's already said, what do you want to do? Well, we want to promote a page post, so we'll select that middle option. It's going to say, what post do you want to promote? Let's see if I can find it. Here it is. Looking forward to presenting this morning. So you see, it does take a little time, but it's far more beneficial. It gives you a preview. This is what it'll look like in the newsfeed. This is what it'll look like in the right-hand column. Not very exciting, but it was just a demonstration. Now we get into the targeting. So you can target just like you can do before in the, I hear that I'm breaking up in the audio. I hope, is it any better now? Maybe you can type in and let me know if it's any better with the audio. Okay, it's fine. Thanks, folks. That's strange. Anyway, so you can see what we've got here are the same kind of basic targeting. We can target there. But here's the best part, right? I want to target people interested in education. So I'm going to start typing in education. And we've got two different ways of targeting people. Down here under precise interest, if I select this, what precise interest means, and what it really should say is target people who like this page. So we're looking for people who like the page education. And that's going to give us, if you look up here, 20,000 people in Canada, exactly that age, 21 years or older, who like education. But if you notice, there was another one, and there was this, education. The pound sign in front of it means that this is going to reach people who like pages generally about education. So here's another example. Let's say that I want to do something on cooking. So I'm going to type cooking. But it turns out there is a page called cooking. There's a page called Cooking Mama. So I can target those specific pages of people who like those pages. But if I target this one up here, then I'm going to get people who like pages generally about cooking. So that'll include the Food Channel. It includes people who like pages about recipes. So it's just broader in that way. So it's much, much more effective. We'll get into these other ones, these custom audiences, in a second. But that's one of the really effective ways of doing it, is to promote the post. And that way, once you've got it promoted, you've got access to a whole bunch of far more effective tools. at your disposal. So let me just find one here that I've promoted. Here's one, promote the five mistakes post. So that was the post that drew people here. And you can see that I've reached out to a very specific group. So in this case, I wanted this ad to go to people who are of this age and who liked the page called Meeting Planner, who liked the page called Event Planner, people who liked pages about, that's what the pound sign means. So I reached out to those people. You can see I've actually split mine up. I've got one ad that goes on the news feed on desktop computers, and this is what it would look like. Here's just a little demo. Is it not going to show us the demo? You know, sometimes that's buggy. And then I've also got an ad that targets the right-hand side of things. In the Facebook Ads Intensive, we'll show you how to actually target both of those. Sometimes Facebook only lets you do it on the right. So that's why it's a bit problematic, we find. Okay, on to mistake number two, mistakes you're making with your photographs. People like to put photographs in their ads. It's great. It's important to do because it generates stuff. But if you've got, let's say, a restaurant, I see this all the time from restaurants. Restaurants will put an ad of, for instance, a version of their Caesar salad or something like that, and that's no good. We want something that generates that really resonates with people. So here is the perfect Facebook ad. Now, it sometimes I have to say this is just statistically these perform better. It may not be perfect for your business, but statistically we find it has five components. The perfect Facebook ad, the photo for it, is a human face smiling, looking right into the camera, matching your target demographic. And do experiment with putting a colored border around the photo. You see this from time to time. So here's a couple of examples. That's what the custom border looks like on the left. On the right, human face smiling, looking right into the camera. It really does resonate with people. However, there are some rules with ads. Your photo has to generally match your business. And we see this all the time of people breaking this rule, unfortunately, of people, you know, posting. The one that I saw was an ad for like a Groupon type group couponing system. And the photo they used was a gorilla, I'm not making this up, a gorilla pulling down the bikini bottom of an attractive model. I mean, come on. How does Facebook get that through? Sometimes it gets caught in like a secondary review. If you are targeting based on gender and orientation, you can't mention that targeting criteria in the ad. So if you run a dating site for gay women, you can't, in your headline, say, hello, lesbian friend. You can't mention the targeting criteria. No shock value ads, I think that speaks for itself. But the most important thing is it can't contain, the photo can't contain more than 20% text in them. Here's an example of what happened to me recently. When I first promoted this webinar, this was the image that I was using for it. Five mistakes you're making with Facebook ads. And then at the bottom it said free online training. And for a brief moment, which is to say maybe about an hour or two, the ad started running. But then soon enough it was denied. So let me show you why it was denied in the ads manager here. Oh, it's not going to show it to you. Isn't that strange? Yeah, they're always changing stuff around. Anyway, it was denied because I had more than 20% text right here, right? And Carla is saying that the 20% text rule gets them in their department every time. It's true. I had to change it to an ad that looked like this, which actually, when I think about it, this is actually a little bit better, I think, in ads. Free online training is up top. I think it's better than that. So there is a way to test it, and you'll go back and forth on these things, and it's quite frustrating. There's a quick link that I've created for you on how to get there, and it is a bit.ly link. It's bit.ly/grid20. Now, this will take you to a page on Facebook site, which will let you test whether or not your ad, your photo, contains more than 20% text. It's a very boring looking page. It looks like this. What you do is you say choose file, you upload the image, so I'm going to upload the first image that I did. Now, I should have done this first, of course, and tested it, but I just took my chances. And it's going to load your ad up into the page with a grid over it. So what you do is you come along and you click on every box that contains text. And watch down here in the right-hand area. It's going to start adding up. Okay, so far so good. Only got 16%. But when I add these, oh, I'm over. and that's why it got denied. On the other hand, when I went, and I had to play around in Photoshop to kind of get, you know, things a little bit smaller and to get it to fix, to set up crop properly, but eventually it worked. So now when I put, say, the text is right here, and it only occupies 12% of the image. So really important, we see that at my company, EngageQ, happening all the time. The third mistake that people make is they don't track conversions. A conversion event on Facebook or any digital marketing is anytime someone's completed a business goal of yours. So if you have an email newsletter and you want people to sign up for it, then the conversion goal is you want people to register for it. If you're selling products, obviously you want people to buy. If you have a conference, you want people to register for your conference. So those are the business goals. And what most people unfortunately make the mistake of doing is that they will put their they'll put their ad out there, and then they track things like clicks. So they'll say, okay, well, we generated 500 clicks from that ad. But do you know how many clicks actually resulted in sales? I tell you, that's what conversion tracking does, and it's really important that you do it. I'm going to walk you through how to do this really briefly. So first of all, just so we understand kind of the whole component, the whole setup of things, this is Facebook. So you've got your ad account, you access your ad account for your personal profile, and then under your ad account is your brand page. So ads on Facebook are set up in campaigns, right? So just like I said before, we could create an ad that, let's say the destination is your Facebook brand page. And in fact, what we want to do is create multiple versions of that ad, right? Targeting different locations on Facebook, targeting different people, different ages, maybe changing up the headline, so that you do this multivariate testing. It gives you the opportunity to make sure that you're actually using the best ad. So the destination, that's what the red arrow is, the destination of those clicks is your Facebook page. It doesn't have to be. Like I showed you before, one of the destinations could be a post from your Facebook page. But a third type, like we did at the very beginning, is to send people off to another website of yours. So let's imagine this is your website off Facebook, right? This is yourwebsite.com, and it's got your standard pages, about us, products, your e-store form, that's where people fill out the form to buy your product, register for your conference, or sign up to your newsletter, whatever your conversion event is, and so on. So it goes through the same process. We set up the campaign, we set up the ads, but the ads click destination goes to your e-store form, let's say. So the ad might say something like, hey, buy this book. And when they click on it, they go to that e-store form. Well, you know that when you buy something online or you register for a conference or you sign up to a newsletter, as soon as you click submit, it spins for about 5 seconds, and then you get a second page, and it's the thank you page, right? This is the page that says, you're subscribed to our newsletter, or congratulations, you've now bought the book, or welcome to the conference. It's not the form that they fill out, it's the thank you for filling out the form page. That's where you're going to put the conversion tracking code, because that order confirmation page will send a message back to your campaign saying to Facebook, someone has reached this page. In other words, someone has completed the form. And that's good. That's what we want. So let's step by step do one of these things. So let me just go into the back end of my website here. Now, this can work on any website, of course. You know, you've got, what am I doing? How am I going to log in here? I have a new password manager. Well, here we go. And, oh, for goodness sake, it's that one. Because what you want to do is put the actual code into the back end of the page. So I'm going to actually show you what the Facebook ad intensive page looks like so you can see the conversion tracking on it. And I'll explain how to get to all the conversion tracking in a moment. So here is what some of that code looks like. It's messy looking. However, this is how you set it up. So the first thing you do is you get your conversion tracking code. So you go to your ad manager, and you click on conversion tracking. Now, this is the code that you will put on your Facebook brand page. Excuse me, on your website of the checkout. And it's really easy. You just create a conversion pixel, and you say, this is someone who has bought my ebook. Just to help you, what is it? Is it a checkout? Yeah, it's a checkout. We'll create a pixel. You get a little box that's got this code in it. copy the code, and then you dump it into the back end of your website. Now, this can be in different locations. You know, if you've got a, let's say, a Facebook, or excuse me, a WordPress page, then you put it into the page there. On MeetingBurner, for instance, which is the tool that you're all using to get to this particular webinar, somewhere in here, and I forget where, I think it's Manage Meetings, My Meetings. No, Dashboard. Maybe it's under Settings. Somewhere in here, of course it's not going to show it to me because I can't find it around my account maybe. Anyway, it's a bigger registration page. There it is. So you can see somewhere in your back end of your whatever system you're using, it's got a little area for ad tracking. So you paste that there, right? So just to back up a little bit, I've said to Facebook that I want to track conversion events on, let's just use the webinar as an example. When people register for my webinar, I want to know when they've actually done that. So you find whatever your back-end system is, a way for you to put that code in. Not all of them have it, but most do these days. Now, if it has an actual value dollar event, let's say that you're selling registrations to a conference and the conference costs $399, if you change this up here to $399, and then down here there's another one that says value, change that to $399. If you want to change the currency, you can as well, though it's not that important. Then when Facebook actually reports back how many conversions, it'll even tell you how much money you've earned. So in other words, that ad will say, this ad cost you $45, and it's generated $800 in income. Really, really important to have there. So once you've got that, you click Close. It's going to reload the page. There it is. Now, don't worry. You're going to see a bunch of these that say unverified or inactive. Inactive means that the actual code hasn't fired for 30 days. Excuse me, for 24 hours. So, and that's fine because, you know, I haven't had a sale on this particular one for 24 hours. That's fine. So don't freak out when you see that. So now that you've got that conversion tracking in place, you just set up your ad like you would any other ad. So we're going to go over here to Campaign and Ads. We'll create an ad. I'll say that one. Promote a post. And let's just accept everything. And down at the bottom, see this, it says track conversions on my website for this ad. And then it's going to say which conversion option. You'll recognize these from the form before, but it's this one, it's bought my ebook. Easy peasy. It's very helpful to do it that way. And that gives you a chance to see right in the ad manager how much money you're actually making. So conversion tracking, really important. In the Facebook Ads Intensive Program, which we'll talk about in detail near the end of this, we go into extensive detail on how to set it up, some tricks to make it even more effective, and so on. Module number 4 is under targeting. There are some great tools in Facebook, particularly something called custom audiences and lookalike audiences, where you can actually reach very specific groups that you couldn't do through the ad manager by itself. When I launched the Facebook Ads Intensive, I targeted people who were part of the Ads Intensive. So if you were a student of this program, you would see this particular newsfeed post, or in the right-hand column, it would look like this. The only people who saw these posts or these ads were people who were registered to my program. So how do you do that? Well, first of all, obviously, it helps to set up a conversion pixel, right, which we did before, to track those things in the first place. But then you use a custom audience. And when you're filling out that ad setup form, you just tick off which audience you're going for. So let's say that you run a conference, and you want to reach people who attended your conference last year. You give Facebook a list of the email addresses of those people. That creates a custom audience. And then when you're setting up your ad, you just check that off. Attendees 2002. So why would you do that? You might want to send out an ad that looks like this, maybe not this particular text. Last year's conference sucked, but this year will be much better. Do you want to come? The only people who will see this ad, in other words, the only people you're paying for, are people who attended last year. Now, a little bit of a note on this. This only works if the email address that you have on file for them is the same email address that they use to log into Facebook. So let's say use the conferences as an example. If you find that if a lot of people register for your conference using their business email address, you might not get a lot of matches because most people log into Facebook using their personal email address. But let me show you how some examples of what you could use. Obviously, you could include people who came last year. If you've got a list of employees at a specific organization, and sometimes they're pretty easy to get, you know. I mean, it's often just first name dot last name at name of company. Or you can also use custom audiences to exclude people. So you can say, I want to reach everyone in the medical industry for our medical conference. I want to reach everyone in the medical industry, but I don't want the ad to go to people who've already registered. You exclude it. Or if you did a survey, I don't want to this ad to be seen by people who rated our conference low. Send it to people who've on your email newsletter. Maybe you've got, maybe you're a software product and you're releasing a new version. You can put ads product you're trying to sell. You can even just target one person. And to do that, it's really easy. You just upload a list of one email address and give it a custom audience. And then only that person will see it. So let me show you that really quickly. And there's a couple of questions. Joanne says, do these people have to already like your page? No, that's the beauty of this. They don't have to like your page at all. In fact, what I do, I've got a campaign running almost all the time. Let me go back here and show you. And it's to generate more likes on my page. Manager ads. So here under get more page likes. And I've set up a number of different ads. And we can see that one of the ads that I've set up are email subscribers of mine who have not already liked my page. And that custom audience is simply a list of people on my email newsletter who haven't yet liked my page. Isn't that great? Custom audience is very powerful. So watch this. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to go and create a new, thank you, Carla. I see that you're on the webinar as well. Carla just liked my page or is following my personal page. So we'll go up here and create a new ad, and I'll show you how to set that up. Okay, so we'll go create an ad. Here's the page. When you go down here, here are all the custom audiences that I've got. The people who attended my summer school, people who are on various newsletters of mine, people who attend my webinar, you will become part of this group as well. So how do you set up a custom audience? You do that in what Facebook calls the Power Editor. Power Editor only works on the Chrome browser. It's free. It's just an additional tool on Facebook. And we only have time to show you the custom audiences part of it, but it's really extensive. We cover all sorts of details in the ads intensive on it. So if you're using Chrome, you'll see this link here, Power Editor. Click that. The first thing you need to do that's different is you need to download all the data. Now, here's why, is that all of the operations you'll do on this happen offline. So first we want to download all of your ads. So click download up there and just accept all the defaults. It's going to go grab every single ad, every single campaign. You see it doesn't take long. And then once you've got them all, you're done. You can start working on them. So we'll go to active campaigns here, and you can see there are the ads that we just showed you. Email subscribers I already liked. So it's a lot quicker to set these things up. But here's how to set up a custom audience. Go over here to audiences. Now again, you'll only see this in the Power Editor. Go to create an audience, custom audience, and then you just give it a list of emails. It accepts TXT format or spreadsheet in CSV, and it will go through and it'll say, all right, now here's an example. Like, well, let me find my e-newsletter. So my e-newsletter has actually got about 3,500 people, this particular list that I've got. This has got about 3,500 people, but it only matched 2,000 email addresses. That's why it's a smaller number. Tip for you. If you tend to be doing the same audiences over and over again, like I tend to for meeting planners, for instance, I like to target this group. And unfortunately, there's no way in the regular editor to do that. You've got to manually type it in. But you can do that in the Power Editor. You say create a saved target group, and we'll call it Sunshine. I don't know. No, let's call it Cooking. Then you just start adding the precise interests as you would ordinarily. And then once you save this particular section, and remember to upload, uploading will actually send all that data to Facebook. Then you can use that. They will show up as a custom audience, and they will reach people who you've already put in this list. So that's very helpful as well. So custom audience is incredibly powerful. Don't forget, once you've done everything, click the upload button, and that will save your changes over to Facebook. Custom audience is incredibly, incredibly powerful. There's literally a full hour we do just on custom audience in the ads intensive. Target. Retargeting powerful. Retargeting works by reaching people who've already seen your website. I have appeared on the New York Times screenshot of the New York Times. My banner ads have appeared on the CBC's website. And when, you know, when I showed up on the New York Times website, I actually had friends call me saying, "You must be doing really well. Like, how much are you spending? Because you've got, you know, just you're spending money on the New York Times." But here's the thing is that these ads will only reach people who have visited my website before. So you won't see my banner unless you've been to my website. And you see this all over the web, by the way. You just might not be aware of it. Check the bottom right below. I saw this on a CBC page because I'd been to the Barcelo website before. Incredibly powerful. You can target people right in their news feed now. There's two systems that I use. I use Perfect Audience and AdRoll. These are links to get to them. They are affiliate links, so I get a little credit out of them if you go there. And you actually will get, I think they put $53 in your account to use it, and you wouldn't get that by going right there. So take your pick. I've been using Perfect Audience lately. I don't have time to go into it in any detail, but let me just show you what the setup looks like so you can see the Perfect Audience. Now I paused my ads, so you'll see that in the chart running a bit lower. So I paused the ads there for a little bit, but let's just go back and see what we got out of it. So we'll see last 30 days. So I have spent $78 in the last 30 days on retargeting, and that has generated 13 clicks to my site. That's not a great rate. In fact, it's quite high. The cost per click, as you can see down here, was $6. That's too high for me. Now, you will want to pay a bit more than just, you know, 5 cents per click, because these are really targeted people. These are folks who have already gone to your site. And in fact, you can target them based on where on the website you've been to. Very advanced stuff, so it's quite helpful. Obviously, we get into that in much more detail in the advertising intensive program. So for 30 seconds, let me tell you, and you may have in fact already won free admission to this. I've drawn a name, so stick around. The advertising intensive program is an on-demand course. You can take it at any time, on your iPod, on your iPhone, on your web. It doesn't matter. You can access it anywhere. There's 6 full-length videos ranging between 45 minutes and an hour each. There's an audio version if you want to listen while you're jogging or in your car, and everyone has a complete transcript if you prefer to read online. It's a PDF. It'll work in your Kindle. It'll work in your iBooks and so on. We have 6 primary modules. First module, we talk a bit about how to get advertising for free on Facebook. That's exploiting EdgeRank and hacking it. And you'll also learn my secret post that gets incredible engagement. Second module, we talk about boosting posts. I know we only covered it for about 5 or 6 minutes. In this module, we go into it for a full hour on the right way to set up, and in fact, how to tweak that boosted post audience to triple the effectiveness of it. Then in the third module, it's about all about campaigns, how to stay clean, how to make sure that you get an ROI tracked, and then most importantly in this module, what to do when things go wrong, because as you send your ad out to a lot of people, it becomes more visible, sometimes to people who don't want to see the ad, so how do you respond correctly? The fourth module is quite detailed. It's a bit nerdy. It's understanding how to bid correctly, how to extend the budget to get more money out of it. We talk about the 3 primary bidding strategies that I use to drive costs down. And then the fifth module, we talk about custom audiences, lookalike audiences, and domain-sponsored stories. Those 2 we didn't have time to cover today. Those will push people to your website, and lookalike audiences will target people who are similar to what's on your custom audience. The 6th is a big, long Q&A session. It's about 2 hours, every question you could answer. And you actually do get, if it's important for your work, you get a certificate of completion. It will have your name on it, not Fozzie Bear's, just to prove to your boss that you did it. So the Facebook Advertising Intensive is normally $297. Until the end of this week for you folks, though, it's going to be $97. That's 6 on-demand modules. There's also, if you get it by the end of this week, I guess that's by the end of today, I'll put in some bonuses as well. You'll get a free copy of my book called Bash Tagged, which is how to respond to a Twitter attack, a free bonus module specifically on my swarm methodology. Now, this is a keynote speech that I give for 5 figures at conferences around the world, so you will get that as well. And finally, a tutorial of a video walkthrough of the brand new Facebook Insights backend. So all of those things, usually it's $297, so this week, I guess today really, for $97. Lots of people have been through it already. This is one person at the Rushdale Community Health Center who called it ridiculously helpful, saw great results from it. Monica Humberg, who is already a pro in herself, thought that it brought her to a whole new level. Okay, now I'm getting embarrassed. I hate promoting myself. It does come with 100% money-back guarantee. That's all I'm going to say about the Ads Intensive program. If for some reason you don't like it, you take it for any reason at all, if you're not seeing results from it, you know, we'll cover it off. We'll do a free tutorial, a free in-depth, you know, personal call. I'll see if I can figure it out. If it's still not working for you, we'll give you all your money back. Now, you may have already won it. You may already have this. So here is the winner of someone who is on the call. Julia, if this is you, please email me. Actually, I've already got your email address. You have won. I'm just looking through my list, actually. Julia has dropped off the call, so I will email Julia as well. So the address to get there is toddmathen.com/FBAI. toddmathen.com/FBAI. And that's it. I want to thank everyone for coming. If you've got any questions, by the way, pop them in by my email address, and that is todd@toddmathen.com. Or, of course, if you want to, if it's easier for you, if you're already on Facebook, just go to facebook.com/tmathen, not Todd Mathen, but tmathen, and just post your question right on my brand page, and I'll be more than happy to answer it. So thanks, everyone else, for coming. Really appreciate it. Hi to everyone who showed up, and hope to see you again on the Facebook Ads Intensive. Thanks again, everyone. Bye for now.